In today's video, we are going to have a look at the bullish scenario for Bitcoin this year, a scenario which can bring the price of Bitcoin to $100,000 and even higher this year. And yeah, we are also going to have a look at the short-term bearish scenario. We talked about that in the previous video as well, but I'm just going to mention it in today's video. And I'm going to show you as well how this scenario what we are seeing right here is actually aligning with another chart as well, and why Bitcoin right now is still not looking so bearish at all. So guys, it's going to be a very interesting video. Make sure you watch it till the end. And yeah, first of all, let's start with this Elliott wave count. And I've been sharing this wave count already a couple of times with you guys, and the reason why this wave count is such a significant wave count is due to the fact that it has shown a lot of significance in the past, and we can see that the corrections, the ABC corrections, are actually quite easier to recognize than the fifth wave structures to the upside. So I don't know for everybody who's remembering this period of time, but right here during this period, we exactly predicted the bottom of the C wave right here with this correction, which is a extra confirmation that this most likely is a ABC, which is followed by a fifth wave impulse wave, which I right here called the third wave in this bigger five wave structure. And right now it looks like we have been we have been seeing a nice ABC correction so far as well. And what we also can see is that the level we have been retracing through so far with this ABC correction is quite significant if we measure the Fibonacci retracement tool from the second wave right here, the second wave correction to the third wave. Then you can see that we retraced exactly to the 61.80%, which is a very significant level, and it would make sense to see a bounce from here to form a bottoming pattern and to see actually the bottom of the fourth wave and eventually enter the fifth wave. Right now it looks like, guys, that everybody, the majority of the people out there, they are focused on the bearish scenario, that Bitcoin is going to see lower levels. And although that is still possible, I still think that right now, if we have a look at different charts, this might be, although it looks unlikely right now, might be still the more likely scenario that we are going to see. And let me first of all go to a different chart, and that is the pattern chart where we normally look at right here. And I've been saying right that we shouldn't make any drastical decisions before we actually get a confirmation. And right here we can see that we haven't seen that break. We still riding on support. We are still trading within this pattern. It could definitely be a bearish pattern where we have a descending triangle, right? A declining resistance right here. We got a horizontal support. And yeah, eventually the price is moving within, and it is possible that we're breaking out to the downside and that Bitcoin is going to reach the levels of $24,000. That is definitely possible, but we have no confirmation of that scenario yet. So I would definitely would recommend, if you think Bitcoin is going to see lower levels, wait for that confirmation, drop below 30,000, retest. And that is the confirmation of a bearish scenario. But as long as we are not yet seeing that, there is still quite a likelihood that we are going to go up from here. Guys, I want to show you another chart, and that is the line chart of Bitcoin, actually, which is not looking too bearish. So let's go. We can change right here the chart to a line chart. Then let's get rid of the drawings, and let's bring out one of the most important indicators, the relative strength index. And guys, what we can see here is, in general, the price of Bitcoin is trending downwards, right? It's making lower lows during this whole consolidation period. But what we are seeing in the RSI is actually the complete opposite. We are seeing higher lows. And let's bring out the MACD to get an extra confirmation. Let's see if we can find that true in the MACD as well. And yes, we are seeing that in the MACD as well. The MACD is trending upwards, which means that we are seeing a divergence in the momentum and in the price. And normally when we are seeing a divergence, especially right here on a daily time frame, it could be a early signal of a trend reversal, and this would align as well with the ABC correction that we have seen potentially have seen so far in the Bitcoin price. So there's a lot of signals right here that are coming or that are showing a lot of confluence that we might have finished the correction and that we can start the next fifth wave structure to the upside, which could bring Bitcoin to the levels of $100,000 and above this year. But let's think for a second, okay? Let's say that that is going to happen. How would that look with the different markets and where do we have to be careful of? So let's go back to the other chart, guys. Let's go back to the Elliott Wave Count chart. Let's go to the candle chart and let's bring back the drawings. So let's say we are going to see something like this. We just finished an ABC correction right here and we are going to enter the fifth wave structure to the upside. This scenario aligns actually quite with the S&P 500, with the regular financial markets. So guys, right now, when we have a look at the S&P 500, then we can see that we are entering the parabolic phase, right? Which most of the time is followed by a correction. So I wouldn't be surprised to see a big correction in the regular financial markets this year or by the latest beginning next year. As actually, I'm expecting a correction quite soon in the regular financial markets, and that is due to a kind of unique reason. That is due to a Shemitah cycle. I've been talking about that in my previous videos as well. Recently, not that much, but this cycle occurs every 7 years, and we have seen that in the dot-com crash. We have seen that in the housing market crash in 2008. We actually seen this Shemitah cycle in 1929 with the Great Depression. I've been writing an article about that. I also have an indicator which is tracking that. But yeah, actually the Shemitah cycle is starting September this year, the next one. And I think this actually can be quite a significant one. And it is aligning right now with the regular financial markets entering the latest phase of a bull market, the blow off top phase. If we have a look, for example, at 2008, we also have been a multi-year long rising channel, and eventually we left the rising channel to the upside. We saw increased volatility, and eventually we had a top. We crashed back into this rising channel, and that was the start of a major correction in the regular financial markets, which lasted longer than a year. That was the 2008 housing market bubble pop, as most of you guys know, in the housing market crash. And I think we can see something similar like we've seen in 2008 or in 2001, where we have seen the dot-com crash. We might even see a bigger event than we have seen in 2008. But I think it is quite interesting that this right now, the chart is aligning and is approaching the Shemitah cycle, which has been predicting the previous crashes in the stock market. And I will make a dedicated video about this, guys. I will make another video about it where I will just solely go into the Shemitah cycle. So for everybody who's interested in that, make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified whenever I upload that video. That is going to be very interesting. But what I basically want to say in today's video is that this scenario in the regular financial markets, which of right now we know has a quite direct correlation with the price of Bitcoin, due to the fact that the incentive of investors in the regular financial markets is similar to the incentive of the investors in Bitcoin. So that's why we are seeing quite a direct correlation. And if Bitcoin right now would enter the fifth wave to the upside, which could align with the stock markets right now, the regular financial markets entering the blow-off top phase, then they are both in the same period of the cycle, right? They are both entering a certain extreme, a certain peak, and that could also mean that they both are going to enter a certain crash or bear market at the same time, due to the fact that they are correlated. They have been showing a correlation for a significant amount of time, and we haven't seen any proof yet that that has been changing. So that is just something I'm thinking right now, that this is a potential scenario that we are seeing with Bitcoin and the regular financial markets. And that is also the reason why I've said in my previous video, sometimes it's better to wait. Like right now, it's better to wait for a clear confirmation until you are going to participate and going to be active in the markets again, due to the fact that it is just quite confusing and we don't really have a clear direction right now in the Bitcoin price. So I think it's still, there are a lot of arguments to be made that we are going to see a reversal from here. I personally still hang on to my opinion and to my analysis that I think that right now that still there is a higher chance of seeing a reversal right here. We still have to see whether that reversal can result in the fifth wave to the upside, which could still bring the price of Bitcoin to 100,000 and above by the end of this year, or that this bounce will result in a retracement. But yeah, honestly guys, I'm personally still quite bullish on the price of Bitcoin, and I see that the majority out there on social media and the sentiment right now is just actually quite bearish. But I'm also saying that you have to consider the bearish scenario, because when we have a look at the pattern structure of Bitcoin right here, we got a horizontal support, declining resistance, that is a descending channel or descending triangle. Normally a descending triangle is a bearish formation because we are always more likely to break the horizontal support or the horizontal resistance in a triangle formation. Right now that's a horizontal support, right? So we've entered this formation from a downtrend as well, which means that most formations, they can function as a continuation pattern. So that means that we have a trend, a certain formation right now, a triangle formation, and eventually a continuation of that trend. So those are all the bearish signs right now. So I think we definitely have to consider that this is a possibility as well, but we have to wait for a clear confirmation in order to say with more confidence that this is actually going to play out. And that could be a nice moment to try and short Bitcoin, or maybe to hedge into some stable coins and buy Bitcoin back at a later stage. However, right now, I still think we are seeing quite some bullish signals, and it would make sense for Bitcoin to form that bottoming structure right here and to go into the next uptrend, due to the fact that we have negative funding rates, we have a divergence in the relative strength index, the MACD is confirming that as well. We are on the golden ratio if we measure the Fibonacci retracement tool from the second wave up to the third wave, which is normally a significant level for a correction of the fourth wave, what we are seeing right now. So those are all signals that are pointing out for a potential reversal right here. But like I said guys, right now we still have to wait for a confirmation, but I would definitely not be extremely bearish in the current market conditions of Bitcoin, because there is still quite some light at the end of the tunnel. Guys, I'm very curious what you think about my analysis right here. So let me know in the comment section down below if you think that I could be right and that there is still a higher likelihood right here to reverse and enter a fifth wave structure, or at least see a significant bounce. Or if you think that Bitcoin is going to break the horizontal support and going to see lower levels, then let me know as well in the comment section down below. Then guys, for all the traders out there who are interested in trading Bitcoin or variety of altcoins, I'm recommending a couple of exchanges below my videos, and you can, if you sign up using one of my affiliate links below the video, you will get a extra bonus signing up to one of these platforms. And I'm personally using the Bybit platform to trade Bitcoin and a variety of altcoins with leverage. Right now, if you sign up over on the Bybit exchange, you can get an additional bonus of $600. Bybit is actually by far one of the best exchanges to trade Bitcoin and a variety of altcoins. Recently they've launched actually a new update on their platform, and right now you can also trade Bitcoin and Ethereum on the spot market, which normally was the advantage of VMAX, right? Because VMAX is also one of these exchanges that I'm using, and the advantage of the VMAX platform is that normally you can trade Bitcoin and a variety of altcoins on the spot market, and also with 0% fees. So that is actually quite interesting. Then we have the Prime XPT platform, which is offering more than just crypto trading. On the Prime XPT platform, you can trade the regular financial markets as well. well. So if you are interested in shorting the S&P 500, once we are going to see that crash after we have seen that blow off top, you can do that over on the Prime XPT. You can even short the regular financial markets using Bitcoin as collateral. So that is quite nice. They also offer staking right now, so you can stake your stablecoins over on the Prime XPT platform. There's no KYC, so that is quite interesting. So for everybody interested in one of these exchanges, you can find all my affiliate links down below in the description or in the pinned comment. Then guys, if you enjoyed today's analysis, make sure to scroll below this video. Hit the thumbs up button, that is very much appreciated. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon so you get notified whenever I upload a new video. I want to wish every single one of you an awesome day today, and I will see every single one of you in the next video.